I'm Tariq Barry. I'm an audio-visual composer, or at least that's the name that I found for myself, because it's not a really very well known or very well established profession, but I make video and I make music. I make them come together through programming code. Yeah, that's what I do. So what I'd like to do is provide people with the visuals and with the audio, like with some kind of a hanger. Like you can hang your own emotions on it. It's a thing that gives some kind of structure, and it will invite you to make your own story to it. So it's not going to be a coat in itself, but a nice hanger to hang these emotions on. If that makes sense. The reason why I chose to go into the combination of music and visuals, it's hard to explain, but I just got very, very excited when I saw Aphex Twin and Chris Cunningham's work together for the first time. That beautiful combination of video and music just felt, I guess in a way, just really new to me. That's kind of the thing that attracts me to it, is that I found it beautiful, but also new. So I'm feeling there's this whole new world of audiovisual music, which is not really cinema and not completely music either, but there's so much still to explore there, and that's just something that really excites me. It's like creating a new type of reality. Especially with programming, you can create a virtual world, and that virtual world will express itself through sound and visuals. It's its own thing, it has its own rules, and it doesn't need to tell a story like cinema does. So it's more like that abstract storytelling sense. It's like music, but it's not music either. When I create my work, I automatically go to some kind of experiences that I think are like psychedelic in a way. They're quite trippy. They are very far away from words or from even things that I can explain. Very often I cannot say what I want to say. I just know that that it feels as if I'm reaching some kind of an emotion or some kind of a state that I don't really know so much in normal life, but which I do really want to feel more often. It feels honest, even though I can't really say in words what that honesty really means. And this type of honesty, this type of coming very close to some kind of layer within yourself, does disconnect me from space and time in some way. It disconnects me from normal space and time, where you do things and you think of emails, and I do enter a different type of world. That is really schizophrenic in a way. It's really schizophrenic in a way to be making something that is supposed to, in my experience, go beyond all of the technical time space stuff to really go free in, but at the same time I'm using programming to do this, which is almost the complete opposite. Programming is very much about telling the computer exactly what to do at which point in time. Time is super important, space is super important. Every little dot that I have in my software has a very precise space also. So that's an interesting contrast. It's very difficult to go from the programming mode into this creating mode. They are sometimes quite far away from each other. It really feels like I'm also a different person. But one thing that was very much specifically created for these performances that I want to get into more right now is this part with Lea Fabricant, where she is singing and bringing actual life from real time and space. She's singing and putting her image and her sounds within the software of mine. And what happens then within the software of mine is that all these recordings of time and space become part of a virtual other time and space. And I can move around within my virtual space and go back to the beginning of the performance by moving to where the first loops were recorded, and I can move towards where the later loops were recorded. So it becomes almost like a collage in 3D of actual times of real life. It becomes a remix of real life in a sense. In the end, as an audience, we still get a linear story, but the linear story is made out of a collage of times and spaces which are completely remixed. You know, Lea, she records loops one after the other, But at the end, the way you hear them is sometimes the complete opposite way around, and then back again, where it stops halfway. Some weird effect starts happening, and you know, time and space really gets mixed up in that sense.